So what AHALife is that we are a curated online marketplace, and we're going after a segment that is actually connecting independent designers and artisans in the premium and luxury space outside of ready-to-wear. When it came to kind of sourcing and picking products for the site, I really went with my gut. And I think that a huge part of what AHALife is about is the idea came to me when I was actually living in Sweden. At the time I was running a company called Casal, which is a Swedish activewear company. And in Sweden, in the wintertime, the sun goes down at like 3 p.m. So you're just like, it's darkness, there's nothing to do. It was really bored, so spending a lot of time online. And I was just really bored, and really felt that there was nothing inspiring, and you know, also realized how amazing New York City was, which is where I lived prior to moving, and just being like, wow, there's so many incredible products in New York that I took for granted, and now that I'm living in the middle of nowhere in the darkness, there was really just nothing I could look at or that actually shipped to Sweden. So the idea came from just personally just wanting to like, why couldn't I buy all these really cool independent designers and artisans across my entire lifestyle at my fingertip on the web? Like, why is that so difficult and why isn't it convenient? So it's always started from that place, but I think that together with the curators when we first started, and now we actually have so many applications coming in that we don't have to do that much outbound, but it started with this authentic place of really sourcing products that I really personally needed. So it always had, it had a personal perspective versus a commercial perspective that I think really helped a lot. Yeah, I think this audience would probably get it because everyone's pretty young. I think shopping offline is just really inconvenient now, and I think that luxury is a lot about convenience, right? So. I think that customer service matters a lot. So that's something where we spend a huge amount of time and money and people investing in customer service. So that piece is important. But aside from that, I think if you can't buy these designers, and we have designers all the way from Tokyo or from Paris, it's a luxury that you can now buy them online. So that's kind of how we think about it, is giving you access to something that you otherwise didn't have access to before. You know, e-commerce is having a moment where there's a tremendous number of mono brands that are going direct to consumer. A lot of people, there's now like the Warby Parker of everything, if you will, and there's so many companies that are spawning, going from manufacturer direct to consumer, and that's, I think, a really, really powerful trend of transitioning consumers to think of online as the original destination to buy goods versus the secondary destination to buy goods, and that's actually helped marketplaces and online retailers, I think, because it changes the shift in mentality of how consumers see online. And I think that trend will become more and more powerful, where companies more often will now launch online and then go offline versus the other way around.